Hello, it's Adela with ADASH, and I would like to tell you some basic information about ADASH online monitoring systems, what devices are used for online monitoring, and what software will help you with data collection. Online monitoring systems are used for reading the vibration on machines continuously. We use devices we call online units. We have two types of them. First type is online unit A3716. This unit contains four measuring boards. Each of these boards has four AC channels, four DC channels, and one tacho channel. It means that online unit A3716 has 16 AC channels, 16 DC channels, and 4 tacho channels overall. All of the channels allow you to measure and collect data simultaneously. Second one is online unit A3800. The difference between these units is in number of measuring boards. This unit has only one board, and by default, it can measure 4 AC channels, 4 DC channels, and 1 tacho channel. But it can be extended to version where you can use also 16 AC channels, 16 DC channels, and 4 tacho channels. This is configured with a license. As there is used only one board, we use multiplexer for switching in between these channel groups. It means that only 4 channels measure simultaneously. Firstly, it is necessary to connect sensor to online unit. For each type of online unit, there is different way how to connect sensor. For A3716, you need to connect sensor like this. For A3800, there is a different connection. You can see it in the picture. Now your question could be, how to set up these online units and how can you make them collect data properly? At the beginning, turn on your online unit. You can do it with power button on the front panel. As a next step, it is necessary to establish network connection between online unit and a computer for data transferring, because service for data collecting is running on the computer. If you have any person focused on networking and IP addresses, leave IP address setting up to this IT person. IP address setting is not as simple as it may seem. Incorrect settings can cause more troubles than good. Online units have their IP addresses set from production. It is fixed IP address in this private segment. 3-axis stands for a number from 110 to 209. IP address set from production is on the front panel of online units. This default IP address is used for direct connection with online unit. Newer units from year 2022 have two Ethernet ports. The left port is set for automatic configuration with DHCP, and the right one has fixed IP address mentioned earlier. You can choose one of the following options to set network properties for your online unit. The first one is to connect keyboard, mouse, and monitor directly to online unit. Online unit behaves like a computer with Windows operating system. You log in with username and password. This information you can find in manual for online monitoring systems. Then you change network properties. The second option is to connect remotely to online unit with remote desktop. Connection of online unit into network requires to have computer in the same network segment or to be connected directly to online unit with correct IP address. To establish remote desktop connection between your computer and online unit, you need to change IP address of your computer temporarily based on following guide. Please be aware that once you change manually IP address of your computer, it will be disconnected from network. When your online unit is set based on your preferences, you need to change IP address settings of your computer back as it was. Go to Windows Start and write Network Status. Choose Change Adapter Options. Click with right mouse button on Ethernet. Choose Properties. Choose IP version for protocol. Again, Properties. And set IP address manually. First three numbers for your computer IP address must be the same as first three numbers in online unit's IP address. The last one must be different. Click to field for subnet mask and it fills itself. Confirm it with OK button. Then you can run application remote desktop connection. Go to Windows Start, write remote desktop connection and press enter. Log in with unit's IP address. You can find it on the front panel. Now, click on Connect button. Fill in username and password. It can be found in online unit's manual. Press OK. Now you will get following window. It needs to be confirmed with Yes button. Following steps are the same also when you want to set IP address with directly connected keyboard, mouse and monitor to online unit. You need the same username and password to connect. Once you are connected, you can see online unit's desktop and window for device monitoring. If you need to change network properties of your online unit, click on icon for network connections. Do necessary changes and save them. Please remember that in case you are connected with online unit IP address and you change it, you will be disconnected from remote desktop. You need to log in again with the new IP address set. For correct setting of online unit in business network, please contact your IT department. In case you still do not know how to set up network properties of your online unit for the first time, you can contact ADASH for assistance and we will help you with these settings remotely. Next step is to connect dongle key to computer. You need to plug it into USB port of your computer. It is necessary to have dongle key drivers installed. You can check easily if drivers are installed or not. If dongle key is lighting, then drivers are installed. If not, you need to install them. In this moment, we have sensor connected to online unit. We have correct IP address set for online unit. And we have dongle key connected to our computer. So, how to create online database where you can collect and store the data? First of all, please check that your DDS is running or updated to the latest version. You can check this version on our web adash.com. When you start DDS for the first time, it depends if you have ADASH flash drive with license connected to your computer or not. If you do, then DDS is automatically checking this flash drive and it is searching for license file. If license is found there, your DDS will automatically import this file and it is started in licensed version. If flash drive is not connected to your computer and you just copied license file, for example, to your desktop, you need to import license file to DDS manually. Otherwise, it is running in limited free version. Go to tab Help and click on License. Click on Import button. Now you need to find your license and import it into DDS by Open button. Confirm license with OK button. After this, you will be asked to restart DDS, so license import can take effect. Before you start to create your online database, you need to decide what type of database is the best for your purpose. You can choose MySQL Server 8 or Microsoft SQL Server. First type mentioned is a free software. It is great for smaller and medium databases or projects. Microsoft SQL is better used for large projects, but it is paid software. You can use also Microsoft SQL Express, but there are some limitations for database size. Maximum size allowed is 10 gigabytes. Now you can start to create your database. Go to tab Tree and choose New. As an example, I will choose to create MySQL database because I will use ADASH Server installed. ADASH Server installation is included in previous video. We need to fill in the basic information such as name in DDS. You can name your database as you want to. It will be shown to you like this in DDS. Database name SQL is the name shown on database server. Should be without capital letters and special characters. Server, it is for location where ADASH server is installed. In this case, I have ADASH server installed on my computer. It means the same computer as server, so I can fill in localhost. Username and password are set by default. You can find it in manual for online monitoring systems. Keep in mind, you need to choose type online for online units. Otherwise, you will not see online tab in these options. Click OK and you will get new database window. Now it is needed to add online unit to this new database. Click Online tab, choose your online unit type, click on Add button and fill in network ID. It is unit's IP address. Fill in also DDS name. It is name of online unit shown in DDS and confirm it with OK. Online unit is added and we can close this window. Keep in mind that online unit name has to be clear and make sense. You can have more online units in database edit, so you need to distinguish them from each other. Now we create department. Click with right mouse button on database name. click on Add Item and type name of department. In this case, for example, it will be Hall 1. Confirm with OK. Click on Hall 1 with right mouse button and click again on Add Item. Here we add machine. It is necessary to choose type here. Fill in name of the machine, for example grinder, and confirm it with OK. For each machine, we need to create measurement points. Click with right mouse button on grinder and choose again Add Item. Type needs to be measurement point. Firstly, we need to add sensor here and set its parameters. The most important is to set sensitivity, unit, and ICP. We need to set up also channel where sensor is connected to online unit. Let's choose channel 1. Online unit needs to be chosen here. Choose the one we added, name this point, and confirm this window with OK button. For measurement points, we need to add what we want to measure. Click with right mouse button and add data cell. You can define your own data cell from options below. For our purpose, we choose data cell from the templates. For example, we choose template for RMS. We add also second measuring point. I copied it as it is faster option, but it can be created the same way as the first one. Measure point has been copied with all the settings from the first point. We need to change channel where sensor is connected. Click on measurement point with right mouse button and pick properties. Channel will be changed to channel 2. Confirm it with OK. Here we have database tree completed and we can start the measurement. To start collecting data, we need to go to online tab. Here we need to press start button. Then we click here on current checkbox to see actual current values on the machine. And that's it. More settings and configuration for value saving will be shown in the next video. Or you can also find this information in manual for online monitoring systems. Thank you for watching.